stereo with 51. Everything in Nevada flies.
Go get your man.
And I feel like Nevada fly gon' recap this.
So all y'all wanna know what happened, I'ma tell you what happened. He got smoked.
I give you ladies something to shake the beefy cheeks to. You hear me?
I'm a different type of sandwich, very sexy, I'm a menace. Looking for some beefy, shawty shaking, Mr. Beefy. Throw that cushy pussy, if you feed me, I'ma eat it. Just don't play no games, if you do it, I'ma beat it. Yeah, Mr. Beefy.
You already know what it is, man. Salute to the subscribers, that notification gang. RiceGangClothing.com for the merchandise. You heard me right. Let it click and blame. Hit your man. Follow me on Instagram. By the underscore fly. Tell your mama I said hi. Yeah. Tay-Rock. Salute to Tay-Rock and everything that he's got going on personally and professionally. He was just hosting an event, Wartown Battle League, down in Warner Robins, Macon, Georgia with Clone. Salute to everything in them that they got going on. His battle versus Chilla Jones is on the URL app. Showtime SP and Chilla Jones have been doing round for round bar breakdown recaps and all of that. I got Tay-Rock winning the battle any way you call it. It's just I've seen it more than once. And the thing about it is, right, I know there's a lot of people who feel like this and feel like that. Rock was able to control the battle. Control means a lot. Cadence, performance, outbar, you better relax. Like, them reactions and the way he was able to talk to Chilla in that battle, it's just something for me that takes it over. On the app, they got it 3-0. It might be closer than a 30-30 ball, but what I will say is Rock showed that he could dance in them rooms versus pens. You know, the difference between I and K. I'ma lead a pen leaking, the difference between I and K. Like, he did really good against Chilla Jones. I'm just saying, and it is what it is. In a battle that going in, a lot of people did not have him winning and felt like he was going to lose. I feel like the love be different. Like, when you win or when you're winning, it doesn't really get much celebrated or talked about as if you're losing. Like, battles that people felt like he clearly lost, they waved the flag and had a parade. A battle that the fans have him on the app and a lot of the people who talked about having winning, a lot of people ain't talking about so much. Chilla did his thing though, you know what I'm saying? And Chilla's gonna continue to do what he does. He's a phenomenal MC. He beat K-Shine. He's still on his run. He's having a great year. He's had a great year. He's had a last, like, come on. This is Chilla Jones. He's dope. But, Yemings! T-Top. Salute to T-Top, who has a battle coming up with none other than Swamp on the URL Super Fight. You know, the card was released. And that card it was circulated, like, mad people shared it, you know what I'm saying? A card that was supposed to be the card, but then it wound up being the card, but it wasn't the card, and it was like, do you believe in the parallel damage control? I do. But anyway, now T-Top, who has Swamp on that very same card, kind of got at Rock and wanted to know what was up with him. He said, y'all tell Tay-Rock some madness coming around. And then Rock immediately responded by jumping in his bag. Don't say my name until you face Swamp. Go find that man. Go find that man, B. Go find him, B.
Stand out here like the Three Stooges of Harlem or something, B. They're gonna let this nigga come and take your shit. Ain't you a motherfucking man? Man, until you show me where that man is at. Until you find that man, you dead up here, man. You dead, man. All right? You hear what the fuck I'm saying, man? Now get the fuck off my stoop, man. Go ahead, man. Go find that man, B. Go find him, B.
Go find that man and don't come back until you find that man. T-Top responds, Twerk battled him. We booked already. You the only one running from somebody. You don't want to see me, Swamp, or Twerk, SMH. Rock then says, I said in about 3 to 4 interviews, I'll battle you, Swamp, or Mike P, or Twerk for Summer Madness. I don't give a fuck. Stop trying to paint the narratives with that John, running. You not even scary for me to run from, bro. Chill. And Rock goes on to tweet, Summer Madness coming around and niggas want to say, hey, where Rock at? Laugh my ass off. F out of here. I'm going to get a Summer Madness check regardless. Don't look for me now. Niggas wasn't worried about me all year. Basically saying that a lot of y'all wasn't worried about me all year. Now that I got a little heat up, you know, some heat in here after the Chilla performance, You know, battle rap is like what Calico said. They pull the equity out of each other. Once somebody starts buzzing again or gets on a little run or does something in a battle, people want to pull the equity out of them to, you know, get a battle with them. Now, I'm not saying that's what's happening with T-Top, because T-Top is a very talented individual who is very capable of having his own battles and matchups with very qualified opponents. He's battling against Swamp, and him versus Swamp should be a phenomenal battle versus two dope MCs. But Summer Madness is coming, and you know that's a card that everybody wants to get on. You see Easy the Black Captain out there trying to get goods. You see Math trying to get goods. You see even K-Shine and Hollow the Dawn had a little back and forth, jingle, jingle. Hollow the Dawn, Energy God, said, Sean better not run for me after the 17th. I'm Summer Madness ready. Someone tag Lil Homie. Like, someone tag him. You know, these two have been talking about a battle for quite some time, but it never happened. And K-Shine responded with the LOL yawning emoji, like, nigga, I'm not scared of you. Hollow the Dawn does have a lot to prove in his battle coming up versus Rum Nitty, because a lot of the polls that are out have Rum Nitty clearly winning the battle versus Hollow the Dawn. But Hollow the Dawn, it's like a crazy paradigm shift, because what Hollow the Dawn is able to do very well, Rum Nitty doesn't do very well. What Rum Nitty does very well, Hollow the Dawn doesn't do very well. Give me more. Explain. I will explain. Hollow the Dawn has phenomenal rebuttal ability, phenomenal freestyle ability, phenomenal angles. He's a hell of an angler, and he has a good cadence, and he's able to rap multi-syllable, lyrical, metaphysical. But like, he's able to do that, and he's able to switch flows. Like, he has different pockets of flows that he can go into and different bags that he can jump into that he uses to break down different MCs and opponents. He's able to do that at a high level. Rum Nitty, on the other hand, is a remarkable puncher. Probably the line for line, the gun line king, probably the best puncher ever. He probably is. Like, if you really look at things and you take the best punchers, whether you want to take Conceited, Be Magic, Av, who else? Rum Nitty, obviously. There's a lot of other folks out there, even slept on punchers like Mac Myron and other folks like that. I will probably put Rum Nitty at the top of all of those guys, because he can literally, I've seen Rum Nitty literally do three rounds, whole battle, every single line is a haymaker. Like, he literally is a, like, some people build up to the punch. Rum Nitty's punches build up to punches, which build up to haymakers, which, like, on the way up their punches, then on the way back down in the flow, their punches. This shit is crazy. I've never seen anything like it. Like, remarkable. So, he's able to do that. And if the crowd is catching every one of them, they go from oohs to ohs to ohs. Like, he, you've seen his rounds versus Cortez. I have not seen Cortez get dismantled by an opponent like that in a very long time. And they battled twice, but the second one was way worse than the first one. Every time somebody battles Rum Nitty again, he battles someone else. He battled Drugs in the tournament twice. The second time is always, he does you, it's crazy how he can find more name flips and more work to give you after he's already battled you. He battled both of them twice and 60 both of them. Rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle. But Hollow the Dawn has definitely, he's gonna have to bring something. He's gonna have to bring something, because if he's just gonna sit there and just use angles and if the shit don't hit like that, you're getting punched back to back to back to back to back, it could get a little dark for him. So I think Hollow should be more so focused on the Rum Nitty battle and not looking past him to K-Shine, because dog, Rum Nitty is like, let me just put it like this though. Rum Nitty don't get a lot of, or hasn't got a lot of the battles that like the big super names, the Luxes, the Mooks. He got an Iron Solomon, which to me is a very good legacy battle. But he ain't got none of the God tiers like that. You're the first one, and he's going to be trying to make the very first example out of you. Don't think nothing different. End this off with the Tay Rock and T-Top. Both have the way that they stand on it. Both are dope MCs, and I think that would be a fire battle between both of them. You know, Rock is going to do what Rock does. Like, that's just, he don't duck smoke when it comes to different opponents. Like, the only battles that people probably have been calling for and wanted to see him take that I could think that haven't happened yet are T-Top. I'm surprised him and T-Top ain't battled yet, but hopefully that's happening. And maybe a Danny Myers. You know, I know Danny's wanted him for years, but the thing is, Danny has to start making the right career decisions and smartest moves. He's on a card coming up battling against Jada Nightwing. While I feel that's a dope battle, if Danny Myers beats a Jada Nightwing, to me it doesn't really do much, because you just have Real Sick, who's in that same echelon of the newer cats, and you didn't do well versus him. He owes us a good performance versus Real Sick, but I mean versus Jada Nightwing, but he's gonna have to bring it. And there's some more battles on that card. Jackboy Man versus Oops. Oops is going to smoke you. I hope this gets to Jackboy Man. Oops is going to smoke. Oops is getting you clean out of here. You're gone. He's going to fuck you up. 3-0 Oops. Nah, I'm just playing. Jack said he wanted me to talk some shit. But Oops has been rapping different on URL, Jack. So I hope that you know what you're getting into, because Oops has been rapping real, real different, and that nigga can beat you. Don't get it fucked up. And Danny's with the Horsemen too. You be talking all that about Loso and about A-Ward and all of them. Oh, nah. He coming to have one of them conversations with you. But overall, Tay Rock versus T-Top is something I would definitely like to see. And also the Hollow to Don versus K-Shine. Hopefully both of those happen in the near future. Other than that, man, salute to every single one of y'all, man. Vida _ fly on Instagram. Hit your man. Gone.
And I'll give you ladies something to shake the beefy cheeks to. You hear me? I'm a different type of sandwich, very sexy, I'm a menace. Looking for some beefy, shawty shaking, Mr. Beefy. Throw that cushy pussy, if you feed me, I'ma eat it. Just don't play no games, if you do it, I'ma beat it. Yeah, Mr. Beefy.